Thank you, and appreciate the standing ovation for them. I live across the street from the national office on Thomas Circle in Washington, D.C., and I would go in there on the weekends, a Saturday or Sunday, and these people were there quite often, including Super Bowl Sunday, all-day Super Bowl Sunday. So they did put a tremendous amount of work into this, and we appreciate it quite a bit. And I think the attendees, I hope you really have enjoyed this week as well. This next presentation we're going to give is really an honor, and every year we get to do this, and we're very humbled to be able to present the Sentinel Safety Award that was actually created in a prior NATCA administration, but we, you know, inherited this significant award. But last year at our convention in Minneapolis, we renamed the award. As many of you know, we had an untimely death of Congressman Oberstar, a very dear friend of ours and also to many in aviation. He was the first recipient of the Sentinel of Safety Award, and we renamed it after him at our convention in Minneapolis. And the award was originally created as a way to honor a member of the aviation community or a legislative community or both that's displayed outstanding achievement in the advancement of aviation safety. Former winners have been Chairman Frank Lobiondo, Peter DeFazio, Jerry Costello, Steve LaTourette, Frank Lautenberg, former Administrator Jane Garvey, former Administrator Randy Babbitt, former ALPA President Lee Moak, and our first one again was James Oberstar.
This year's winner is a personal friend of Trish and mine. A true friend to NACA and no stranger to CFS. She's a defender of safety, and safety is in her DNA. She was appointed to the NTSB in 2004 and became the chairman in the NTSB in 2009. Last March, she left the NTSB to become the president and CEO of the National Safety Council. But at the NTSB, she investigated over 25 major transportation incidences, including the DC Metro Rail collision, the Kogan air crash in Buffalo, and the mid-air over to Hudson, and she played a very vital role in the Dreamliner 787 battery problem. She's chaired many, many hearings and testified in front of Congress frequently. Doing the right thing for safety is not always the popular thing. She's brave, she stands up for safety every time, and that's why she won this award this year. Please play the video.
Sitting out here on the hood of this truck, looking up at a caramel-colored sunset sky. Checking my watch, doing the math in my head, counting backwards when you said goodbye. Will those runway lights getting bright?
I appear before you today during one of the safest periods in the history of U.S. commercial aviation. But let me be clear, the absence of accidents does not mean that our work is done. Safely defying gravity thousands of times each day requires constant vigilance. At the NTSB, we've seen the deadliness of distraction in all modes of transportation. And it was so good to see people from the FAA, from NATCA, and science-based researchers sitting around in a working group trying to address fatigue together. You won't see fatigue on the list this year. Much was done to address our recommendations.
You looked out your window, saw me running down the runway, just like I was crazy, but that fence is too high. So I'm just sitting out here watching airplanes take off and fly, trying to figure out which one you might be on and why you don't love me anymore.
So if you can actually read that first line, it says to Deborah Hirschman, Sentinel of Safety, and that was from Jim Oberstar in 2004, before this award was even thought up and before he received the first Sentinel of Safety Award from NACA. So in a real-life example of divine will, she is the perfect recipient for the first James Oberstar Sentinel of Safety Award. Please stand and welcome our chairman, and always our chairman, Deborah Hirschman.
Oh my goodness, I almost feel like that was my funeral. That was so amazing. Really, thank you so much. That I was just so lucky to be a public servant. So lucky to work with so many people who cared about safety and to be able to represent the work that people do every day that means so much to our country. One of the things that Congressman Oberstar, and I had the good fortune of knowing him for many, many years as a young congressional staffer, a junior staffer, you know, I don't know that anybody ever knows who's going to end up doing anything in life. Congressman Oberstar treated everyone with respect, and I am sure when I was 22 years old, he didn't realize that one day I would be the chairman of an agency that he actually helped create in 1967 when he was the staff director of the Public Works Committee. But he taught me that people are important. Whenever he saw me, he asked me about my family, he asked me about my kids, and I just want to stress that people are what's so important. I was so thrilled to be able to see some of my old colleagues from the NTSB. Brian, Mike, and we've got a team that's here, and no, you can't buy those NTSB jackets. I think everybody who's come up to the booth has asked them if they can buy a jacket. We have so many people who work so hard for safety, and when we talk about Sentinels of Safety, it's you guys. I work in an environment where I fly every day. And you all are the true sentinels of safety. I'm so appreciative of what you do every day. And people are important. And I know that you all and your family make lots of sacrifices. And I don't know if I talked about this a lot when I was the chairman of the NTSB. I didn't really want to get him into any hot water. But do we have any folks from Indy Center here in the audience? Okay, I have to give a shout out to Indy Center. My cousin, Romy Hirschman, has worked at Indy Center for 28 years as a controller. And I know that all of you, no matter where you work and no matter what you do, that you have to make decisions, you have to make sacrifices about when you're gonna get sleep, what you're gonna be able to do with your family, and even about coming here and what shift you have to work when you go home. So thank you all for being the true sentinels of safety. And I noticed that you all had some chips on your table that said safety is no gamble. I want to actually recognize Paul and Trish and say thank you to them. Do we have any folks from the military in the audience? If you could stand, please, if you've served in the military. Thank you all for your service. And if you've served in the military, this isn't one of the poker chips that was on the table, but you all might be familiar with this. It's a challenge coin. And the challenge coins are something that were typically used in the military. I'm a military brat. And I would like to present Paul and Trish with the challenge coin of the President's Office of the National Safety Council. They have been amazing champions for not just all of you, but everyone using the national airspace. And their tenure, I think, as leaders of NATCA has been one that has been unprecedented as far as cooperation, as far as working with other groups and organizations. And I will tell you, at times, relationships between the controllers and whether it's FAA or NTSB haven't always been easy. But I can tell you, under their leadership, things have gotten immeasurably better. And I believe, Chad, that we're in the best place that we've been for many, many years when it comes to NTSB investigations. And so I never had an issue working with Paul and Trish that we couldn't figure out how to make a win-win. And that has been a hallmark of my experience with them, and I suspect yours too. So I'd like to present them with my challenge coin, and I know I'm the only thing standing between you and the lunch buffet, so thank you all so much for this honor.
So we're going to send you to lunch, and 1:40, you come back.